Venezuela bans import of cryptocurrency mining equipment. Report. Reportedly the cheapest country in the world to mine Bitcoin, Venezuela authorities have cracked down on a local mining operation by banning any new import of mining hardware, including certain type of graphics cards and a computer as well as ASIC miners. While the government has embarked cryptocurrency with the launch Petro, the state crypto tied to the value of oil, the stance on local money is not always as welcoming. The current Venezuela economic crisis is the worst the country has ever seen, leading to the hyperinflation of the currency, crippling debt, food shortage, and widespread civil unrest. As the government printing of huge amounts of money, the minimum wage lost purchasing power. The government continued to print money while raising the wage as well, spiraling the economy out of the control after an Intel collapse over falling oil price. The Bolivar, Venezuela's national fiat currency, has lost 99% of its value over the last 5 years, while inflation has gone up at an annual rate of 16%. Used as a confetti in a baseball game and crushing weighing scale of delis, the money is essentially worthless. The government has announced a plan to cut 3-0 from the end of the currency stating on June 4th. Venezuela is reeling from hyperinflation. Many Venezuelans turned to the cryptocurrency as the collapse began to get worse, using as a store of value in their effort to try and preserve their dynamic savings. Thousands began to mine Bitcoin and other cryptocurrency as well. Due to the exploding cost of living, the government placed a freeze of the cost of utility bills and the movement of the cost of paying the electricity, phone, water, and heating bill is about the same as the price of a cup of coffee in a cafe. It costs around $530 per BTC. Venezuela is the cheapest country in the world to mine Bitcoin, and Caracas in particular has become a mining hub as the citizens struggle to survive. But no longer. Local media reported yesterday that a new government policy set out in April has been inefficient, banning mining equipment to prevent people from abandoning the state currency entirely. Customs authorities have been seizing computer equipment by air and sea in the nationwide crackdown. Shipping companies Liberty Express and DHL has adopted to the new measures, either updating their pages to inform users of the new restriction or sending out notices to customers directly. The National Association of Cryptocurrency will meet with the superintendents of the cryptocurrency and related Venezuela activities to discuss the issue and perhaps outline a time limit to the ban. Superintendent Carlos Walsh said in April, "We are in all evolution process to select and authorize companies and are qualified to import and market digital mining equipment and be responsible for the respective generating in our country." Vargas warned people to be careful that the purchase by the mining operation as no equipment hasn't of yet been certified or approved by regulators.